Together we shall speak for the law and the land and shall drive the mongrel dogs of the Empire from Morrowind.
I too hate mongrel dogs.
Mind.
Apprentice's retort. Nice.
Is this how you honor the sixth house and the tribe unmourned? Come to me openly, and not by stealth.
What do you mean? I'm coming right for you! Well... between eating scrap metals. Glass as well. Oh, the horny feast. Not even October. Daedric's short sword. Weight 24. Fuck that.
Welcome, Moon and Star, to this place where destiny is made.
You look like crap. It began here. It will end here. Have you any parting words, or would you prefer to skip the speeches and get to our business? You are the challenger here, after all, so to you goes the courtesy of first blow. Now that you have come to me here, there can be but one result. Many times I have considered offering to share this place with you. I considered offering to accept your oath of service. You might try to buy my trust by giving me Wraithguard, Keening, and Sunder. I thought we might once again be friends, comrades, brothers in arms. But I have won this place and power by right of conquest. By right of daring and enterprise, I will not risk it to cunning and deceit. I offer you no deals. If you are my enemy, I cannot trust you. And even if you are not my enemy, I cannot let you live. It will all be decided here. I believe I will prevail, but I cannot be sure, and I am vain enough that should I fall, I would wish to be remembered in my own words. So if you have final questions you ask, ask them now. I have final questions I would ask you, if you would answer. My first question is, are you really Nerevar Reborn? I know no more than you do. By the grace of the gods and fate, I am Nerevar Reborn. That is bitter. Gods and fates are cruel. I served you faithfully once, Lord Nerevar, and you repaid me with death. I hope this time it will be you who pays for your faithlessness. My second question is, if you win, what do you plan to do with the power from the heart? Will you make yourself a god and establish a hierarchy? Or will you complete Akulakan, dispute control of Tamriel with the scepter? Or will you share the heart with your followers as I have, and breed a new race of divine immortals? None of the above? have my own secret plan for the heart. Well, perhaps there may be surprises in store for me yet, or perhaps you obscure your plans on principle. Or perhaps you are an instinctive bluffer. No matter. My final question is, if I had offered to let you join me, would you have surrendered Wraithgar, Sunder, and Keening to me to seal your oath? No. I would never join you. Thank you for your forthright response. And now, if you have any questions, ask them. Otherwise, you are the challenger. I await your first blow. What is your plan for the heart? I will continue to draw divine power from the heart and distribute it to my kin and followers. I will continue to broadcast divine power upon the Blight Winds, so that it will touch each soul on Vardenfell, then more broadly across the waters to the rest of Morrowind and Tamriel. In time, every mortal in Tamriel shall feel the liberating contact with the divine. What is your plan for the Sixth House? The Sixth House will serve as the elite cadre of our movement. As cultists evolve through various stages of enlightenment, they will become, as suits their abilities, either holy warriors or priests. Their duty is to prepare themselves for service. Their joy and liberation is to enter ever more deeply into the profound enlightenment of the divine dream world. What is your plan for the Dunmer? I will free the Dunmer from the imperial yoke and cast down the false gods of the temple. I will lead them out of their ancient superstitions and gift them with intimate knowledge of the divine. Then, perhaps, when Morrowind is once again restored to its ancient glories, it will be time to consider whether the Dunmer should cultivate ambitions of empire. How do you justify your crimes? If, by my crimes, you mean the inevitable suffering and destruction caused by war, then I accept the burden of leadership. The Sixth House cannot be restored without war. Enlightenment cannot grow without the risk of upsetting the tradition-bound and complacent herd. And the mongrel armies of the Empire cannot be expelled from Morrowind without bloodshed. As I have charity and compassion, I grieve, but our mission is just and noble. What happened to the Dwemer? I have no idea what... God damn it! I have no idea what happened to the Dwemer. I have been denied the opportunity to study Wraithgard, and I am not sure how much of Kegranek's lore was invested in his tools, and how much of his own sorcery and mastery. I have long studied Kegranek and have come to admire his wisdom and craft. Someday, after the campaigns of the Sixth House are secure, I hope to have time to dedicate to this mystery. Why are you building a Kulakan? The thing is about a Kulakan is that this is like the first time you even hear about it. A Kulakan will serve three purposes. It will be the champion of my armies, liberating first. Yeah, like it has definitely not been anything that has had any significant mention at all. Maybe at some point, but the Numidian was mentioned briefly, but I don't remember what that was supposed to be. Like they have only said Numidian. That's all. He was doing something. He was like creating the second Numidian. That's what all they said at some point. Okay. Whatever that is. A Kulakan will serve three purposes. First, it will be the champion of my armies, liberating first Vardenfell, then Morrowind, and then perhaps the rest of Tamriel. Second, it will serve as a sower and cultivator of the divine substance derived from the heart. Three, it will serve as the prominent banner and symbol of our cause, to defy the Empire, to liberate mortals from ancient superstitions, and to glorify our crusade against... I am finished talking. Defend yourself. Very well. If you're impatient to begin, go ahead. You are the challenger. You goes the first blow. But before we do that, I'm gonna take a pee-pee. Okay. Our business. Whoa! That's the first blow! Alright, I'm gonna capture you. Your spell did not get a target. Oopsie. How can you kill a god?
What a fool you are.
I'm a god. How can you kill a god? What a grand and intoxicating innocence. How could you be so naive? There is no escape. No call or intervention can work in this place. Come, lay down your weapons. It is not too late for my mercy.
Why can't I move? I don't know. I just don't get his character. What are you supposed to be? Just building a gigantic titan. I mean, I didn't read the instructions, but it doesn't sound particularly
What are you doing?
What are you doing, fool? Stop!
This is the end. A bitter, bitter end.
Can I capture you now? Is the heart still here? Gods took and hid Lorcan's heart beneath Red Mountain as a punishment for creating the mortal plane. The Dwemer discovered the heart while building underground colonies. Highcraft Lord Kagranak created enchanted tools intended to tap the power of the heart. The War of the First Council was fought to prevent this sacrilege. Kagranak used these tools, and the disappearance of the Dwemer race marked the end of the war. Kagranak's tools were recovered by Lord Nerevar and Dagathur. Dagathur was left to guard the tools while Nerevar came to consult with his advisors. In Nerevar's absence, Dagathur experimented with the tools upon the heart and was corrupted. We returned to discover a deranged Dagathur who refused to turn over the tools. When he attacked us, we drove him away. Blah 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 blah. La 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 la. Hello, Lenny. Gone.
Just stab it! Stab it!
Yeah, it's actually taking damage, so. Or should I keep using Keenig? I'm not sure.
Whatever that means, I have no idea what it is. Walk over the bridge. No. Because I'm stabbing this heart. No, it's taking damage. I feel like I finished Quake 1 or something. I could have made myself a god. The disturbance triggered an earthquake, and I had to flee for my life. Oh, is that what I'm doing right now?
You no longer bear the burden of prophecy. You have achieved your destiny. You are free. The doomed Dwemer's folly, Lord Dagoth's temptation, the tribunal's seduction, the god's heart freed, the prophecy fulfilled. All fate sealed, and sins redeemed. If you have pity, mourn the loss.
He's a really cool guy.
Let the weeping cease. The blight is gone, and the sun's golden honey gilds the land. Hail, Savior, Hortator, and Nerevereen. Your people look to you for protection. Monster and villains, great and small, still threaten the people of Vardenfell. Enemies and evils abound, yet indomitable will might rid Morrowind of all its ills. For you, our thanks and blessing, our gift and token given. Come, take this thing from the hand of God.
Hello, Smitty. Yeah, we just finished the game. The Ring of Azura. Knight I 20, restore fatigue 3 points. Oh shit, restore fatigue 3 points. That's exactly what I wanted to make. Yeah, but where's my double sword? Where's the double sword? Hell yeah, 3 points. The fuck is it? It's actually really strong. It's 3 fatigue, plus 3 fatigue recovery per second. It basically means I can throw away my current fatigue ring. Because we are regenerating fatigue now when running. Instead of losing it. Or it being like at a standstill.
Oh, the sun is so beautiful!
Okay. Now what? I kind of want to just use... I'll see the intervention, but... Let's run back to the ghost fence. Fuck you. Maybe in Tribunal we can get enchanting up like 60 at least. Hermamoras dudes? Who? Herma what now? What's a Hermamora? No, that's one of Dogothur's guys. He has tentacle dudes in Skyrim? You know, all of these guys are just... Dunmer who are... corrupted. They're basically turtles. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Except they have. Yeah, whatever you want to call that. Elephant trunks instead of eyes. He is indeed a little bit strange. What do we have here? Sharlopi. I'm still annoyed because we are literally at the last boss, or we just killed the last boss, and all of the enemies here are worse to Soul Trap than random enemies at random data shrines. It's triggering the shit out of me. Even the named ones, like his named Ash Vampires, are worse. It has to be Golden Saints, seems, to be able to make constant effects. Time to repair this spear. Forgetfulness.
What am I supposed to do with that?
Forget it. Exquisite amulet, not bad. Pack of bullshit. scrolls that I'm never gonna use, because just punching people in the face is more damage. Where's that slave? What slave? Hello, Colding. How's it going? You can get out of here now. You just have doors there. Like, there's no one guarding the doors or anything. You just have doors. Excuse me, Sarah, but, well, you're the Nerevarin and a big hero, and I don't really know how to talk to important folk like you, except to say thank you, Sarah, for everything. Can't even ask him about Dagothur so he can tell me. Now that you have killed Dagothur and ended the blight, the skies over Red Mountain are clear and blue by day and dark and filled with stars by night.
A terrible place, I've heard. There's a boat from Kul, if you have any reason to go.
Go ahead, Outlander. What do you need?
But that's not where we're going. Do you not fear the Blight? No, we're the Nerevarin. Of course we don't fear the Blight. Yeah. Were you here when we were in the Azura cave? And we were talking to, like, old Nerevarin, like, people who were attempting to become the Nerevarin but failed. That was great.
I died 400 years ago. Solstheim. Oh, it's a terrible place. Take the boat from Kul.
I guess we're going to kill Vivek. I mean, it seems to be only prudent to cleanse the land of these false gods. Like, the game is just like, yep, that's it. That's it. Like, what do you want? Do you want an ending? Like, you killed him. Good job. What about, like, Vivek and... No. Fuck the tribunal. Nobody cares. We're gonna deal with the tribunal one way or another. Can you please stop the ash storm? We just killed Dagothur. I don't really know who to talk to. Or what to do, if there's even anything you can do. Except just head over to... Now that we're here... see the intervention.
I'm listening.
We go here.
Tidings.
Faith conquers all, Nerevarine. Bless your breath and blood. Praise Almvimsi, praise the Nerevarine. The devil is dead and the blight is gone. The devil Daguthur is dead and all his kin, and the blight has gone too. And the skies are blue over Red Mountain. Alright. Vivek's gonna be like, good job, you killed him. Why did I just collapse? I think one of our blessings ran out. Happened. The blight is gone and we have survived. Now we must dedicate ourselves to rebuilding the temple. And you must dedicate yourself to responsibilities as protector of Morrowind. There is much to do. You still have Kagranak's tools, potent weapons, and the wit and experience of a proven hero. The Tribunal and the Temple are happy to yield to you the duties of fighting the enemies of Morrowind. There are many blighted beasts and horrors that have survived and must be hunted down and destroyed. There are lesser monsters and villains of all kinds who prey upon the people. There are unsolved mysteries and legendary treasures undiscovered. I'm sure you will find much to occupy. We have lost our divine powers, but not altogether. Some token of the people's faith remains, and we shall dedicate it to rebuilding the temple. Now that Daguthur is gone, we can turn our energies to the more humble needs of the people. It is good, honest work, and I believe there is redemption in it. There are still issues to be resolved between the temple and the dissident priests, and now that our greatest enemy is gone, we must reorganize the temple to meet the needs of the people. We have less need of ordinators, for example, and greater need of priests and healers and teachers, and we must find time to mourn, honor the dead. Is that what you think? Why do you sound like a crocodile? Don't worry about it. Beautiful sound. Well, clearly he does. And he sounds really strange. Well, I mean, he's kind of not fighting back. With this character's death, the thread of prophecy is severed. Restore a save game to restore the Weave of Fate, or persist in the doomed world you have created. You have a unique Dwemer artifact. Unique Dwemer artifact. And we also have a Vivek's soul, which gives 1,000 charges. However, I'm not sure if this is viable. I mean, the thing is, we're done here. But I don't know if Vivek is involved at all in Tribunal or Blood Moon. It also depends on if everyone wants to kill us here. Guess that would be a tad annoying. Nah, they don't mind. They didn't really like him that much anyway. Let's have a Google to see if we continue. This. Are we supposed to kill Vivek? Yeah, it kind of feels like they're bad guys. And like, but they did lose their powers, so I mean, eventually they're going away on their own. If you kill Vivek after you finish the main quest, he has much less health and will leave no corpse soul or the back path left-handed Wraithguard since it's no longer necessary. Instead, you're simply left with the message, the heart of Lorcan is no more, and Vivek and his unnatural powers dissolved with it. Yeah, someone else said, after finishing the main quest, I killed Vivek, but I just got the information that I killed an important character. I don't think we need to. I don't think it matters. Yeah, I just wanted to be sure. Unfortunately, he's now taking up Azura's star, but we can't use that for anything until we manage to use Vivek. And we don't have enough enchanting for that. Because you can't buy soul gems anywhere in the entire game. I have not found anywhere reliable that you can, where you can get soul gems. If you just run out, what are you supposed to do? You find them on like random traders, and then you buy them, and it was like two. What will you enchant? I'm not sure. I mean, it depends on. There are a couple of things I want. I mean, I want just fortify strength. That would be nice. I want a pair of boots with jump. That would also be nice. But just a big ass damage spell on my spear would also be nice. Okay, so right now what we're doing is. But there are a lot of options for the constants. Could farm Golden Saints and just put Chameleon on everything. Will you be hunting lost treasures and relics? No, not really. We're gonna do Tribunal and Blood Moon. Like, I know where a couple of things are already. Like, I know where one of the... I don't know what it's called. But there's a shield that... I think it has, like, restore health or something on it. I know where that is. I'm pretty sure I know where the spear is. I know where the levitation boots are, but... I don't feel like going and just grabbing it. Without having any reason to go there. So, what we're gonna do is... We're gonna... take this boat over here.
Go ahead, Outlander. What do you need?
Not yes, to Hlaoad.
What do you want?
To Ebonheart. Right?
I'm listening.
Just don't really remember exactly. Dark Brotherhood. Almalixia is one of the gods worshipped by the Dunmer in the Tribunal Temple. I killed Vivek. Thank you, I must be going. Farewell. What does that mean? What happens if I pick that? Nonsense. You don't know what you're talking about.
You're in good company, friend.
Kill the Bosmer? This poor lad? No, I don't remember what you're supposed to do to get there. Aren't you supposed to talk to, like, one of the leaders here?
Yes.
Or something? It was way too long since I did this last, and there's, like, no information about it.
What brings you here?
Like, Blood Moon, they're like, talk to, you know, go to cool every single fucking guy you talk about. There he is. What's this about the Dark Brotherhood? But yeah, I was on the right track. You say you've been attacked by them? The fact that you're standing here seems to suggest otherwise. Perhaps you have been attacked. That's bad business. I don't know who it is that wants you dead, and I don't want to know. Dark Brotherhood activity here in Bottenfell has almost been unheard of. But I know they have a large contingent back on the mainland. Yes, in Mournhold itself, actually. If you're feeling particularly suicidal, you can check it out for yourself. Of course, it's not easy to get there these days. Even though the blight seems to be gone, Mournhold is wary of visitors from Vardenfeld. There is one way you might get there, though. Speak with Asya Rain about transport to Mournhold. She might be able to help you out. She's a mage who arrived in Vardenfeld the same time I did. Special appointment to Duke Dren himself. Nice woman, a powerful mage. You should be able to find her in the Grand Council Chambers here in Ebonheart.
How can I help
you? Okay. Where's that?
Do you need something?
Yeah, I need to admire you for a little bit. Oh, yes, later, I'd love to. What does that mean? What are we doing later? I feel the same. It's been some time now for me. What? I am Asien Rain. How may I help you? You wish to go to the mainland? That's highly irregular. I'm sure you've heard that they've restricted travel to Mournhold. They've been a bit worried about the Blight, even though it's been reported that the Blight is gone from Vardenfell. They're still worried about possible contamination. What's your reason for wanting to go to the city?
I killed Vivek. Now I want to kill Almalexia.
Before we go and kill Sol the Seal. Why? I fear I've been marked by the Dark Brotherhood, and I wish to investigate. Oh my, I can see why you'd want to get that cleared up. That's dangerous business, though. I can't say I'd be happy to send you off on that sort of fool's errand. If you're sure, though, I suppose I can oblige you. If you need to return to Vardenfell, speak with Effete in the Royal Palace. Take care, friend. Those people are not to be taken lightly. I'll send you there when we've finished speaking.
Mournhold, city of light, city of magic.
City of magic!
Be well, traveler.
Anyhow, we are in Mournhold. We're doing Tribunal next. And then after that, we do Blood Moon. But that is it for today. I did not think we were actually gonna finish the base game today. But we did. I mean, it was only a 13-hour stream. What can you do? But we'll continue tomorrow. Until then, thanks for hanging. Next time. Bye-bye.